Today we're working on a 2000 Hyundai Sonata, and we are going to be replacing the alternator. So the first thing we got to do is we need to remove the serpentine belt so we can remove the alternator. And that's done by this tensioner right here on the front of the engine. It has a little square in there that fits a 3/8 drive socket. I have this special serpentine belt tool that I got, but any 3/8 socket will work. It just has to have this end at the end of it. So we're going to put it in. So let's just put it in there and then just turn it, and it loosens the belt, and now we can just lift it off of one of the pulleys. Let's take it off the alternator pulley. There. So now just let go slowly, take it out. Next we want to remove the battery. Okay, it's kind of a tight spot, but it looks like there's two mounting bolts. There's one on the top right here, and then one below it. First one is 12 millimeter. Next one is 14 millimeter. Okay, so it looks like this bolt goes through, can push back, really tight fit. Okay, on the back of the alternator there's a little boot that comes off, and make sure the battery is disconnected when you touch this, because it is hot. And on that is a nut. Ah, 12 millimeter. Comes off, and now right below it there's an electrical connector. I'm not sure if you can see it. It's a really tight spot. I'm trying to get you guys in there. I can barely see it. You just squeeze it and then pull back. There. So now all that's left is to take this guy out of there. There we go. Shake it around a lot, don't fall out. This is the most annoying part. So we're going to compare a new and old alternator. Here is the new one. Well, they look a little bit different, but it should work. It came with a little bulletin that says that there can be either a one pin or a two pin connector. And they say that this pin right here was never ever even used, so anything you get will work, because both versions only use this top pin. I'm gonna try to give you guys the best shot I can, but it's tight in there. Okay, I want to show you guys the bolt for the bottom brace. What you want to do is you want to put it in first. See how it is right here, going all the way through. put that in first before you start putting the alternator in, and then there'll be a little notch that shaft goes through, and that's the way you put it in. You put this bolt in first, and then put this bolt through the little notch, and then tighten the nut on the other side. Onto the notch thing first. Okay, it's on the notch. Now, let's just hold it up and then put the bolt through. Oh! These tools, this magnet tool is essential for finding dropped bolts. Okay, got it in. This top bolt is kind of tricky to get in. Just make sure you don't cross-thread it. Don't force it in if it doesn't want to go. Okay, let's tighten her up. Okay, now let's plug our electrical connector back in. Okay, now we plug in, we attach the hot wire. You don't want to kill this. All you need to do is snug this up. Because if you tighten it too much, you'll destroy the alternator. There, just snug it up. Doesn't have to be, you don't have to go crazy. Put the boot back on it. Okay, now we need to put the serpentine belt back on. It's a good idea to draw a diagram of this before you take it off, but this pretty much stayed intact where it was. And if you ever don't know, just Google it. Just pull it to loosen the tensioner and then put it over the belt. The pulley. Okay, now go through and make sure the belt is straight on all the pulleys. Okay, let's reconnect the battery. Okay, let's start it up. Forgot we gotta jump it first. Gonna check the battery voltage. Alright, she's charging. We're getting 14 volts. That's it. Thanks for watching.